Hello. How's everyone doing today? Happy Saturday. Just putting a title on my YouTube live stream. Yeah. Okay. Yes, it is Saturday. Yes, we are streaming. Yes, it's going to be a completely boring, normal stream. I am not doing anything planned today. Some days I plan something, and then most days I specifically reject any kind of pre-flight planning. For the reason that I don't want to have to do it every time, you know? So occasionally I allow myself to do a plan. By the way, Star Wars. Star Wars. I like this. This is the original sort of artwork. How's everyone doing? So yeah, I'm gonna have a nice week. We might fly around. We might crash. We might smash. I might do several missions in Flight Sim. I don't really know what I want to do. So I was thinking around. Look at how empty this desert is here. I just thought maybe it'd be interesting to fly around the desert. Like the actual Sahara Desert for a while in a really fast plane, but during the day. Let's see. And there's practically nothing out there. All right, I think this is kind of an area. Perfect. Perfect. Not this plane, though. I was, for some reason, see, I told you I didn't have a plan, but I kind of have a plan, which is to get in a really fast plane and fly over the sand dunes. Why? I don't know, but that's the nature of a plan. You don't really know if it's going to be good till you do it or not. You know what I'm saying? The Deimos G39 Griffen. We don't take it out that much. It's fast. And we'll do, since we're on a desert run, we should probably do something. I mean, would it be too obvious if we did the Splinter Desert? Yeah, I think it would be too obvious, come to think of it. Let's do some, one of these really wacky ones. Italian Air Force. Heck yes. Overweight. That's fine. Does this have even a place to start up? Excellent. And it's, you know, I want some shadows. We want it to be a little earlier in the day. You know, if this is boring, we're going to do this for like 10 or 15 minutes. But if this bores the living crap out of me, I'm just going to, you know, we'll just pick another like European city to fly around. And that's just because that's how things happen around here. Completely off the cuff. Let's see, Bellarama is running a replay. They are having a girl pool party, but I don't think it's till like 1 or 2 p.m. or maybe later. So I'll be done probably by the time Bella's pool party, which is going to have Allie Cakes and Kiara Kitty and a bunch of other girls, I think, are coming in for that. I think it's at Jess's house. Jen's house, sorry, Jen. So I'll definitely want to watch that, but I'm sure that's not till later. So we don't have to worry about that. All right. Cold starting the plane is always part of our mission. What is going on? Is this right? I don't know if this is right. All right. That's right, I guess. Oh, okay. We're moving around. I can already tell you we got to reset the... No, something bad happened with the graphics. All right. Let me see if I can reset this. Hold on a second here. Okay, that's a little smoother. Oh, bugs. You'd think an airport in the middle of nowhere. Well, that's a pretty big airport. I mean, it's pretty, you know, reasonably major airport. I don't really know where we are. Diori Hamani. I'm going to look, first of all, I want to look this up on Google Maps and see if I can get some idea where we are in the world. I think it's Ghana now. Okay, let's put, type this in. D-I-O-R-E Hamani International Airport, Namibia. Niger. Okay. And Niamey is the city. Okay. Interesting. All right. Let's see. I'd like to see that we can get this started up. As usual, it's really hard to even figure out where everything is. Oh, yeah. Avionics, we want that. Fuel on. APU on. Battery on. APU starting up. I think we turn that on. We can remove the chalk and flags, right? Or is that not possible to do yet? Okay, that's coming to life over here. What do we got here? Panel lights. Panel lights. Beacon for sure. Lights, yes, please. We don't need that. IFF, not necessary, really. Taxi lights, sure. Okay, so engine, APU on. So I think we need to crack the throttle a little bit. And then I think we can do a engine start. Let's see if that starts those things going on here in the center area. Yeah, I'm seeing some activity there. Oil pressure. We look out here. We're starting to spin up a little bit there. Yeah, I'm seeing some exhaust gases. We can see, yeah, we're starting to get pressure and speeds out of our engine. Okay, that's starting. It takes a while to start up this engine. Anything else I need to? Okay, landing gear is good. This is all good. Throttle. Do we need to see the pilot? Can I turn the pilot off, by the way? Isn't there a way to turn off the pilot around here somewhere? Maybe not. All right, here. Pilot on, off. Off. Okay, so it was already off. That's the autopilot system. Okay, our HUD is lit up. That's good here. Very good. Is there brightness for that? Okay. Oh, we're getting there. There we are in the back. We're getting there. We're going to have to take off soon and just fly over the desert. Why not? I want to check my other things going on down here. Here, map brightness, panel lights. We don't really need them on. Map brightness, screen, day. Oh, not day. Parking brake on, good to know. Windshield de-ice, I don't think we'll need that, we're in the desert. And then those here, canopy jettison, what's this? Don't need the canopy jettison. Aux is on, okay, yeah, we want to turn the APU off. We don't need it anymore. Brakes are on. That's turning off. The APU is, I believe, coming off. Okay. Where's the canopy open, by the way? Is it up here? Wait, if I remember correctly, it's in a weird place. It's always different, yeah. Just like to hear that sound. Oh yeah, it opens to the side like that. Really cool. I like it. Nice. We can see in there, danger, lighting, inside the rear, nice. All right, well, let's take off. I don't have no idea where we're going to go. No idea, don't care. Yeah, okay, canopy back closed. Oh, canopy is on this side here. Close the canopy. All right, and our radio is on, correct? So we can just request out.
Yami ground KNSH 999 request taxi for takeoff departing straight out.
Oh, there's some little cool planes running around here. Well, we're heading... Oh, wherever we're heading is away from civilization, because there isn't any. So we'll see what it looks like when we get a little altitude. But then I kind of want to do most of this at low level. We'll have to see. This is in the African country of Niger. Not Nigeria, the other one. Acknowledge taxi clearance.
Taxi, hold short runway 27 left using taxiway cross runway 27 left catch 999.
Alrighty. Yeah, we're fine either way. Yeah, we'll take it this way. It's fine. We don't care. The other way, but we're fine. There's more runway this way. This way is pointing us this way anyway. Let's pretend this is the correct direction. It's not. By the way, all my streams are basically the same. The third important element besides me is flying around and doing music later is Diet Coke. You can see I've got the glass, Diet Coke, there's condensation, there's ice. It's not in a can anymore. It used to be. Hold on a second. Hold on a second here. I gotta have some backup. It's more important than flying this plane. All right. Okay. Full power. There you go. Full power. All right. Afterburners on. Stay over the runway. Gear up. Gear up. Gear up. And then boom. A world-famous maneuver there. Actually, we don't want to do that, but, you know, that's why we're in this plane. Okay, afterburner's off. Suddenly see where we are. In the middle of Africa. All right, let's get low. See if we can find some dunes. Okay, hold on. We're going to get low this right this way. There's the airport we took off from. Right below us. All right, where's the desert? Yes, I did. Here. Are we already frequency changing? There we go. Oops. All right, yeah, I like this direction here. Oops. We do have a very effective autopilot, but I don't know how low it will let us go. And we're gonna find out. And how flat this is. It looks like it's pretty flat. So we're going to head kind of northeast. Because that's to the center of Africa. There's just nothing out here for forever, for the long way. Kind of east-northeast. Eventually, if we go that way far enough, we hit the ocean. But we don't want to go that way. We're going to head east. Well, 2,900 feet. And I think these are probably going to end up being not a lot of terrain, not a lot of elevation in this terrain. But you can see it's satellite maps. You know, it's a satellite map. I wonder if there's any evidence of human... I mean, is that a road? Oh, it's definitely a road. All right, let's check that out. But we want to stay under, like, a couple hundred feet, if possible. Just to vibe out. We're at 900 feet. That's not that low. Yeah, this is the kind of vibe I was looking for. 1,000 feet. We have a radar altimeter. I don't know if we do. But supersonic speeds, if possible. You see there's power lines out here. So I guess we can, you know, we can burn some fuel. Okay, Mach 0.84. You see the M meter there in the HUD. Indicating we are now over the speed of sound. We are Mach 1.08. Yeah, this is the Griffen. It is. It's one of the fastest planes I have, and I just want to vibe out over the desert in a fast, really fast plane. What are we at? Mach 1.15. That's at a low altitude. That's about as fast as you're going to do in just about any plane. But I want to get a little lower. I want to be under 1,000 feet. Now, if anybody was below us, the sonic boom would be so loud they'd probably be permanently deafened or killed. Because at this level, you really shouldn't do this. Just because it's bad for the wildlife, you know what I mean? But look at this, there's nobody below us. You can see our shadow, we're still ways up. How much gas are we burning? Most of it. 1.16, that's pretty much, and that's full. So. I guess at ground level, 1.16 is about the limit. But yeah, if we touch the ground, we're going to leave a stain about 6 miles long. I wouldn't recommend it. Yeah, it's a very advanced plane. Telling me to pull up, but I don't wanna. I'm kind of vibing out. But we are low. We are low and fast. There's some people down there. We just murdered them. All right, that's enough. That's enough afterburner. Some planes you can go, maybe at some altitudes, you can go supersonic without the afterburner, but not this one. But we do have those tanks, so we got plenty of gas. All right, so we just moved back out of, so now we're not putting out that enormous sonic boom that we would have been. It's funny, there are, you know, you think there's just gonna be nothing forever, and every now and then there's a little settlement of some kind. Beautiful paint job, red, blue, kind of white. But I think it's the Italian colors. It's Italian. The Italian Air Force, tricolore, we call it. Oh, too high. All right, so there's nothing anywhere, except I see a little dot over here, so we're gonna investigate it. A little more engine going. The other place that it's really amazing to fly over, if you just want to fly over terrain, is Central Australia. Impressive in how bleak and desolate it is. For so long. Okay, there's another settlement here. Or city, village. But we're not over it for very long. I'm trying to stay below 1,000. Just to keep it interesting. But that's 1,000 above ground, above sea level. So I don't know exactly what our AGL is. Less than 900, though. That's for sure. It says GPS altitude 900. And there it's reading 1,100. Yeah, I wouldn't know. I wouldn't want to fly this low normally. It's an expensive plane. But it's not like there's any mountains are going to pop up. Africa is just a big, flat, huge area in the middle. And so is Australia. What is Bosso? Is it a grass strip somewhere? Because if we keep doing this for hours, it's not going to get any more or less interesting, I think. But I just want to fly. If I see anything, I'm going to check it out. I bet it's a little grass strip that we couldn't land on anyway.
town here. That's a moderately good-sized town for Central Africa. Or is that like, yep, your basic piece of grass or dirt. Nope, can't land there. I wonder if we'll run out of fuel. All right, so what's our direct, what's our heading? Current heading of 162. Speed lock, speed mode, heading 162, let's call it. Selected altitude, 1,100 feet. Autopilot on, heading on, altitude mode. Do we have the speed mode on? No. Auto throttle? Ah, we don't need it. Okay, it should be heading us down altitude again to 1100. Do anything. Okay. Normal. Yeah, and you can see in this thing here, there is nothing. Do the biggest zooms here. Okay. Yeah, you think of this area as sand dunes, but it's mostly what you call chaparral. So it's not actually, you know, I mean, there's a lot of sand, but there's a lot of scrub, you call that. So there's a lot of, there's some amount of low energy plant life. Why are we at 2,500 feet though? Right, let's get off the autopilot. Start flying it again. Too high. Can we hold here? That's better. Beautiful clear day, Central Africa. Just nothing there. But I'm kind of into the vibe. A little Diet Coke. Yeah, this will be like a first mission. I honestly just really want to do this for a while. And then we'll do some other mission where there's actual civilization. But I don't know where. Oh, there's something down that direction. Let's make a right turn here. Ish. By to maybe 180. We're kind of going south now, I think. No idea. It's probably, I'm sure it's another grass strip. We'll land there. I mean, you know, it may or may not be possible, but we'll give it a try. Landings are fun. I never really do a point-to-point mission all that much, but I have turned up the audio of the airplane a bit because I'm really enjoying the kind of the effort they put into doing accurate sound effects, especially for some of these planes where you get far away. kind of makes it kind of rumbly sound. Nothing anywhere else. There's just something up there. I don't know what. How far? Maybe it's this. Plenty of gas, though. Get there wherever it is. Let's see, what other views do we have from here? That side view, okay, right side view. This dude, that's your rear, your Rizzo, radio officer. I think it's two passengers, right? Soft keys, these are all good. Barometric. Yeah, oops, wait, nothing here. Smoke, some navigations, navigation lights. Still out in the distance. Okay, Gaia. Okay. Some kind of airport. It's probably a dirt strip. Don't know. Let's find out. Altitude, there is definitely going to be a little turbulence. Let's go to about 170. It looks like there's a lake of some kind here. That should be interesting. Just nothing from the horizon to horizon. I like that kind of though. Sometimes, you know, we fly around Europe and there's always little towns, everything's civilized, people there. Sometimes you just want to fly over someplace where people have maybe never been. And you're like, is that possible? Yeah, I mean, look at this. Look at those people there. Some people got swimming pools. Hey, I don't know. There's people. All right, autopilot off. Let's fly the plane. Yep, okay, fine, fine. Alright, what is Gaia gonna look like? There's a little town, there, okay. Gonna be a little dirt strip. We're landing on it. It's flat, we're gonna land on it. I don't think it's possible. Oh yeah, it's not even. It's not, oh, is that it right there? Yeah. I think that's it there. Let's try it. And land on that dirt strip. Well, let's figure it out. What could go wrong? Down. I don't know if I can even see where this thing, where the dirt runway is now, though. Flaps to landing position. I thought it was kind of way off to the left there. Does it show here? This, yeah. Oh yeah, there it is. I kind of see it now. It's got to be this thing right here. Okay. and stuff. We do have great braking systems. It uses the front canards as air brakes. I'm thinking this is the runway here, but I don't know for sure. Dirt. That's full reversing. Yeah. I love what those canards do. I think this is the landing area, yeah. There's like a little building there. Well, we're calling it a landing area. Nice. All right, we're going to do a second mission. Open canopy. Start the APU. Let the APU come on. APU is on. So we can shut off the main engines, which are, how do we set, is it here? APU on. No. Is there an off ignition? I see there's a starter for the engine, but I don't necessarily see a stopper. Oh yeah, no, it's here. It's the fuel cutoff. Okay, so we can cut off the battery and that. Avionics closed. And that brings out our ladder or exit ladder, and we are ready for a beautiful screenshot, sunset screenshot. Gotta get these flares right. I think we may want to be here. Something badass like that. All right, that was fun. All right, we're gonna do a completely different mission in a completely different plane. Because we got plenty of time. I wanna do this for like an hour. So we got like another 25 minutes or so. Let's see, for one thing, can we get to the main menu without crashing? Because it happens. A lot. By the way, that was, James, by the way, that was the Griffen, or Griffen, Griffen, G-R-I-P-E-N. Which is a European-made fighter. You hear it's the G39 Griffen, but it's a Griffen is the actual plane. It's very powerful. It's one of my, you know, it's one of the really main, you know, super powerful ones. I got the Felon, the Fulcrum, the Griffen, and the Tiger from Demos Inc. Which is, those are all add-ons, and the Tiger is another great one. But I want to fly something that's kind of slower and sillier and stupider. That I haven't flown for a while. Gosh, we'll fly the F-13 over someplace that isn't in Africa. How's it looking in Europe? Looks pretty in Europe. We'll take off from this area here. Do I have time to cold start it? Oh, I always got time to cold start it. It's really the fun part. But we'll do it earlier in the day, so it's not as dark. Yeah, I like to do, well, that's a cool picture, two or three missions. Now, some things are on the docket. I got the Lukla add-on that I spent $10 for the new Lukla airport. And I wanted to do the Lukla challenge, which, as you probably know, is in the foothills of the Himalayas, foothills of Mount Everest. and it's this really tiny canted runway, very steeply canted runway. It's really fun and exciting, and I want to like do it on all my planes that I can. And several, you know, a lot of them won't get that altitude, won't operate at that altitude, or need a much longer runway to take off and land, like a lot of the jets. But I love these vintage planes. This is a vintage Junkers JU whatever. Corrugated, made out of corrugated aluminum, which is the, you can see there, it's kind of tricky on the display, but, and it has an open cockpit. It's a very unusual plane. I think it was made in the late 20s, or at least designed. Let's start getting stuff turned on. Where's the battery? Oh, we need these on anyway. Yeah, that's on. Magneto's on. To mixture to full, throttle to cracked, engine cowl flaps. Can we open these at all? Oh yeah, that's on. No. There we go. Maybe to there, and then we can start, I believe. Starting of the engine. See if that's gonna stay going. What if I turn the oil on? We'll figure it out. That power for that screen, power for this screen. Let's see what we got here. Mixture is good. This is an updated version of the plane. So it's, oh, we didn't do the primer. I guess you don't need the primer. Apparently. Is there a... Okay, well, parking brake on. Good to know. Very good. Very good, very good. Where's our map? There we go. These are all good. And we're looking good. Is the radio on? Yes. We're going to head, I guess, north.
Route KNSH 9999 with India.
Just a real different feeling plane. Obviously, than that jet we were flying. Where you got radial engine... Very common for the time, the most powerful kind of aircraft engine, and this corrugated aluminum skin.
Taxi to and hold short runway 07 via taxiway KENSH 9999.
We're gonna run to that thing there. Oh, we're right at the runway. Oh, that's unusual. Wherever we are, it's another beautiful day, which is somewhere in Europe. Northern Germany or Denmark? I'm not 100%. We'll figure it out. Okay, can we turn the tower and ask to go? Yeah. This plane features no flaps and no retractable landing gear. Very simple. Very simple. And again, this open cockpit just gives it such a beautiful kind of as a view plane. All right, they're letting us take off. So what we're gonna do is the throttle is here. Throttle all the way up there, that one right there. And maintain center of the runway if we can. We get up to 80 or so, it's more than we can definitely rotate off. Lifts off quite easily, beautifully. Yeah, no gear to pull up, no flaps to pull up. And we're gonna want to head, I think, north. Not really sure where the town is, but we'll find it. I think it's that direction. Yeah, maybe. But yeah, flying over Europe, so different than flying over Africa. Yes, yes, yes.
Tower heading north. Looking
at the scenery today. That's not a terribly fast plane, but it'll get you there. Again, mainly because it's not really very aerodynamic. It's very light. It's a very light design. Okay, so where is something? Okay, Blankensee. All right, that's the airport. Oh, there's some kind of gate. I don't know, we'll check it out. So usually that's, a gate is like a keep for a castle, but we'll see. I don't think we need this. Follow this road down a little bit here. I may go back to my map and see if I can figure out where in Europe we are. I usually do that after the fact, after I randomly pick a place. Trim us so that we're not going up. So we're going to need some negative trim there. Alright. We got some nice road architecture here. A highway going over the road. Beautiful storybook European town, wherever this is. All right, where was that thing we wanted to see? The gate? Down here. It's over here. Oh, it's over here. I remember now, we've flown over here a couple of times. It's over here. Now that I remember the city, how it looks. It's one of the updated cities, in the city update number 6, I think. There's this gate here, it's really famous. But the whole city is basically surrounded by water. The old city, you know, there's a newer city that sprung up around it. That's fine.
Tower K and
Lubeck.
Niner frequency change.
And you can kind of see how there's this water all around it, and that's the old city in there, you know. Protecting it with a moat, not a bad idea. And then this would be the protected area. See that this bridge is over there, but other than that, it's completely surrounded by water. Strategically and completely. I wonder how natural this was as an island originally. But this is the whole island. Lubeck, I think. It's got some interesting alignments to the buildings. There's a stadium down there. Yeah, we've been here not that long ago. Like about a month and a half, I think. Maybe 2 months. It was a different time of day, though, when we were here last. But yeah, that's the thing they call a gate. But it's kind of a gate, a city gate. You know, it was designed like, oh, well, if you wanted to get into the city, you had to come through the gate. Because otherwise it was just water, you know. And this is basically the gate. And then there's a solid bridge that you can get over. But other than that, there's no real, I mean, there is now other ways in and out, but that was originally the only way in and out. Just, you know, high security. The equivalent of a gated community in the medieval times. So, you know, pretty big. But yeah, now there's these bridges here, which is good. You wouldn't want to be stuck in there, but those are probably relatively recent. Yeah, I'm just enjoying the vibe. And flying at really low levels that you in real life wouldn't be allowed to do. I don't see any bridges we can go under. And that's the other thing. But, you know, bridges that you can go under are usually associated with, like, you know, valleys and canyon-type cities that are built on rather extreme terrain, and this is not. Okay, we're going southwest, perfect. What's down this way? It's like just industrial area. But yeah, it's open. You're considering, you know, the other thing being open, having an open cockpit means is that it's not pressurized, so you wouldn't want to even go too high. What is wrong here? Yeah, it's probably not advised. So we're going to do it anyway. I mean, this plane does not have floats, although there's a version of this plane that has floats instead of landing gear. And I think it's only floats. I don't think you can land or take off from anything but water, which had been typical back then. You really got to keep this engine on a boil. I guess as long as the RPMs in the green, we're okay. Otherwise, you're not going to get a lot of speed. But, you know, speed's overrated. We were going 450 or four, like over 500 knots in that Griffen. And yeah, it feels like you're doing faster here. And we're doing 81 knots. It's all kind of about how much detail you're flying over. Is there an airfield? I'll find out. About 14 miles. Hello. Hello, old stone bridge. Yeah, I don't know what that is. Uh-oh. A little more engine. Eh, we're fine. It's fine. We got a little water in the system. This is just a lovely little river trip, though. Whoop! Almost hit the. We're gonna hit some trees. It's not good. But you know, shit happens. I mean, if you're not below tree level, what's the point? Shaving some of those trees. Yeah, they needed trimming. This looks like a lock. So is that like a lock? It is, yeah. Some boat locks there. I think. Maybe not. There we are. Oh, let's get a little altitude. I want to see where we're heading here. I wonder if the problem is that we've got a little bit too much mixture. Uh-oh. It's got a slight pause. Give us a second here. Mixture is probably better off down here. That's probably better. Okay. You might be at least burning less fuel. Beautiful. All right, let's get back down this river here. I think it's heading where we want to go, but I don't know. Oh, that is low. We got shadow. No, don't do this. Don't try this at home. Not even in the real world. Or at home. So the bridge here. Another one of those. Whatever those are. Locks? I guess they're locks. Help the boat go uphill? I guess. Alright, we're going to land up here at this airfield. We are approaching. It's going to take another 5 minutes. Maybe speed. I don't care. It's a vibe. There's a lot of little corrections needed on the on the stick, that's for sure. The oak. A lot of that kind of stuff. Yeah, so I want to read the rest of the Zeppelin manual. I'm like maybe a third of the way through it, and then we're going to do a Hindenburg. It actually might be tomorrow. I think I don't need to read the whole manual. I mean, most of it is just general information. So we may try to take the Hindenburg out tomorrow. I think we will. I mean, you know, worst comes to worst is I'll learn something and we'll do a different flight. All right, where was that airport? It's over there. Good. Okay, we're heading that direction. At least an airstrip. We got way too much gas. I don't know why I started with 50% tank. We have like hours of range here. Why the water looks red there. Might be a time of day effect. Oh, definitely too low. Our altimeter is not calibrated, which is why it's showing it says negative. Negative. We could calibrate the altimeter. Not while driving, though. Okay, 6 miles up. So by another 3 minutes, we're going to check out this landing strip here. I think he's right by the river, too. Another one of these boat locks, I think, coming up here. Very nice. Just beautiful terrain, rolling grass, trees. Beautiful. I'm thinking northern Germany, but I'm not 100% sure. But you see there's a lot of wind turbines up there. We're definitely hitting another part of civilization pretty soon. Yeah, I really enjoyed the Griffen too, though. I like all the planes, and it's, you know, flying vintage planes. The other one I really enjoy taking out, and I was going to take out real soon again, is the Mitsubishi Zero, the World War II single engine fighter from Japan. And it's just a real honey of a plane to fly. It's just a really nice flyer. It's hard to describe. It's a good plane. Feels very responsive. Okay, we're heading to Grambecker Heidi Airfield. But meanwhile, I think we're gonna pop out a little bit here into some kind of city area here. Why am I pooping out? My engine pooping out for some reason? No, we're fine. Okay, yeah, we pop out here and there's this lake. Cool. And there's this over here. It looks like the river continues down there. some of these buildings at alarmingly low level. I think that's a good idea. And then we'll check out if this is a grass strip or if it's got concrete or what. I think there are two airfields. Is there one behind it? We'll check this one out. It says airfield, and that it usually means it's just a dirt strip. But we'll see. Not always. Pretty lovely settlement there. We got our engine basically on full here. It's not super powerful, but we don't want to overspeed. Again, you got that open cockpit, and that's going to really determine the fact that you can't go super high or super fast. You need a sealed, pressurized cockpit if you want to go up above certain altitudes and not pass out. Okay, it looks like a nice dirt strip. We're landing there. Yeah, we're like an hour in, so I'm going to do this landing, and we'll pack up. And I'm going to, you know, start playing guitar. I'm going to do a guitar segment. Looking forward to playing guitar. Okay, you got it. We can do this. Let's start over here. And then come back over the water here. And in a similar manner as to when we took off, there's no flaps or gear to worry about. Basically, just want to make sure you don't, that your speeds are right and that you're lined up. Makes a very easy plane to fly. Looks good there. Okay. So that's the line up there. We're going to come down here, make a little turn around. Perfecto. Start lowering the throttle so we can start descending without speeding up too much. Coming in over these trees. Where we are coming in right into the sun. Right over this tree here. Not gonna be able to stop, which is fine. Crashed. So, the other thing is landing on a tricycle gear, especially Microsoft Flight Simulator. If you don't have any way of stopping, we'll go back to the menu. We're actually gonna play. I'm gonna play some guitar now. You don't have any way of stopping. Besides just braking, the problem is you're just gonna go right forward. So braking is very tricky in tricycle landing gears. In other planes where you have a gear in the front, or excuse me, not those are tricycle landing gears. I'm talking about tail draggers, where the single landing gear is in the back and there's two landing gear on the side. When the gear is in the front, then you have a much easier situation to land and brake on, especially in Microsoft Flight Simulator. I think in the real world, it's a little easier, but all those planes, including the Spitfire, the Mitsubishi Zero, they're all landing. They all have the same issue, which is you need a long landing strip because once you're down, it can be very kind of tricky to stop them. All right, well, that was fun. It was very fun and relaxing. And by the way, on the weekends, you know, most people are not here live. Some people are watching me on the VODs. Always appreciate it if you enjoyed the Flight Simulator content. Tomorrow will be more Flight Simulator content followed by me playing piano, but today is a guitar day. So I'm just going to give me a couple minutes to kind of relax and get my guitar going, and then Yeah, we'll be doing that. So you're going to do that there. How's everyone doing? Is everything working here? Got my mic, got my guitar. This is Mike Gibson Les Paul Studio in Warren Cherry, I think Cherry or something. Man, it's a nice one. The second segment today, the guitar segment, me just kind of dinking around the guitar, probably do a few karaoke songs. I'm gonna warm up a bit. Mm-hmm. Tune, quick tune check. I think it's all right, though. Guys are all having a lovely Saturday afternoon. It's gonna be a hot one here in Pleasanton, California. Pretty soon gonna have to get the air conditioning working, or it's gonna get way too hot, which is absolutely typical every single year right around this time of year. It starts getting hotter and shit. All right, I'm gonna start. Gotta sing a song, you know. If I don't sing every day, I'm not gonna get better. Because I don't sing well, but I'm noticing some improvement. All right, this song is called Modern Jesus by Portugal the Man. Come on in, take a seat next to me. You know we got what you need. We may be liars preaching to choirs, but we can sell your dreams. You don't need sympathy, they got a pill for everything. Take this stick, dark cloud. Excuse me. Excuse me. Sorry. Excuse me. That was not a good one. Just take that dark cloud, bring it out to wash it down. But don't pray for us. We don't need no matter Jesus to roll with us. The only room we need is never giving up. The only faith we have is faith in us. The rise, I can't help but shine. And when the wave approaches, take our ashes to the ocean. Who cares if hell awaits? We're having drinks at heaven's gate. But don't pray for us. We don't need no matter Jesus to roll with us. The only room we need is never giving up. The only faith we have is faith in us. We know that we're helpless, at least that's what we assume. But we don't need to prove nothing to you. Let's all stay cool. You don't want to feel blue, cause we won't sell you nothing you can't use. Faith in us. See if I can get my throat cleared up a little bit here. Fizzy Diet, slightly refreshed Diet Coke, which is good. All right. I know you demanded that I play some R.E.M. songs karaoke, so it's going to happen. What should we start with? We'll start with this one. Okay, well, I have to bring you two here. There we go. Hold on. Can you hear that okay? It's a little loud. There we go. Start again. We get it. We'll get it. I just want to get the right. I want to get the chords. That's the. Oh, it opens on G. Hold on. Skip. Sorry. There we go. Ready? Okay, here we go. I was practicing it too. Thanks, Donnie, by the way. I kind of said, it sounds like the original to me. I'm really trying to repeat his, I recently listened, every now, this week while I'm doing it, I'm listening to his performance, Michael Stipe's performance of that song. And I'm trying to get his cadence, I really do enjoy singing these REM songs. I think because for some reason, I don't think I can sing like him, but I'm closer to him than a lot of these other singers. All right, let's do Wonderwall, though. Commercials for 3 seconds. At least get this out of the way. I'm just going to play some random songs. I'm not going to do too much more karaoke. I want 3 karaoke songs is my limit. Wait, what is it? Capo 2?
The day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, should have help me realize what you gotta do. I don't believe anybody feels the way I do back now. Back me, words on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I should heard them before, but you never really had it.
I just have a self-imposed rule of 3. So, no, 3 karaoke songs per stream, just because I wouldn't personally want to watch more than that many myself. If I was watching somebody else's stream, it's just kind of a self-imposed limit.
Mm-hmm.
just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. Just can't remember who to send it to. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I'd always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my, won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You got to help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I'd always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again now. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. And there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. That was the first one of my show. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I'd always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again now. Thought I'd see you one more time again. This is if you think you're running my way this time around me now. Thought I'd see you, thought I'd see you smiling again. A lot of play by James Taylor. Got to play some Cat Stevens. We'll get it all in here. I listen to the wind, to the wind of my soul. Where'll end up? Well, I think only God really knows. I sat upon the setting sun. I never, 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 never. I never needed water once. No, never, never. I listen to my words, but they fall far below. I let my music take me where my heart wants to go.
swam upon the devil's lake. I'll never, 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 I'll never make the same mistake. No, never, never. Little tune check here. We're almost done though. Very nice. Okay, I'm gonna sing a killer song. Okay, we'll do this song. I haven't done this in a while. I've been doing it a lot, but I haven't done it in the last couple, I don't think. Maybe I did. It's called Human.
I did my best to notice when the call came down the line. Up to the platform of surrender, I was bored, but I was kind. Sometimes I get nervous when I see an open door. Close your eyes, clear your heart. Cut the cord. Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold, and I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human? Are we dancer? Pay my respects to grace and virtue, send my condolences to good. My regards to soul and romance, they always did the best they could. Soul out to devotion, you taught me everything I know. Live goodbye, wish me well. You gotta let me go. Are we human? Or are we dancer? My side is final. My hands are cold, and I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human? Are we dancer? Will your sister be alright when you dream of home tonight? There is no lesson we're receiving. Let me know, is your heart still beating? Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold, and I'm on my knees looking for the answer.
Is that's as many songs as I can sing without the voice completely, but it's getting stronger. It's just oof, I really feel it. Doesn't mean I can't play guitar all day, but singing all day is not yet an option. Thank you. right, one last song I'm going to try to sing, though. Look, I got Diet Coke left, so, you know, and this, as you know, the stream is powered pretty much by Diet Coke. House of the Rising Sun by The Animals. Fun. But like every stream where it seems like it just started and then hard before you know it, you know, I just push the go live button like I like to do every day except for Tuesdays. Well, I'd like to do Tuesdays, but I'm just busy on Tuesdays. Ugh, thanks for coming to my stream or watching it on the VODs or whatever you choose. I do the stream pretty much every day except for Tuesday. I just said that, didn't I? Ooh, senility. But we stole some Diet Coke, so let's cheer that. Today, I will be rating Carol Burnett. Carol Burnett inspired me to do the show in the 70s, 45 years ago. What with her plucky variety show that she produced that is now on infinite reruns on Twitch. And she's a Twitch partner. It's pretty amazing. Yeah, Carol Burnett, and she had a great cast. She had Tim Conway, Harvey Korman, Elia Wagoner, and the incomparable Vicki Lawrence. And you know, and I get none of those people, but you, I do get the ability to do this at the end of my show. I'm so glad we had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say so long. See you tomorrow, though. Why not? I say, why not?